with over 1.4 billion inhabitants, China has the highest and probably the cheapest human resource in the world, sending out over 8 million graduates every year, with graduates who are fluent in both English and Mandarin. You'll be asking yourself as an international student, can I actually get a job in China after my graduation? Hey, ladies and gentlemen, this is Business Connect. If this is your first time on the channel, consider hitting that subscription button because we bring to you interesting videos like this on the platform. We talk about China, we talk about life in China, we talk about international students in China, we talk about business opportunities in China. So you will not want to miss interesting content like this. Hit that subscription button and join us on the channel. In today's video, we'll be talking about the possibilities of you as an international student to grab a job in China after your graduation. I'll see you in a bit. Welcome back. So the dream of every international student, or the dream of every student, is to grab a job after graduation, either in China or out of China. But in this video, we will focus on the students who have the dreams of working in China after graduation. Like, what are the possibilities of you as an international student to grab that dream job of yours after you graduate from the university in China? So I will be sharing with you 5 tips that will help you, or that will facilitate you getting a job after your graduation in China. The first thing that you need to do after your graduation in China is that you need to find a company that is ready to sponsor your visa. Because to work in China, you need to have a work visa, a work permit. And there's one thing I want you to understand, that not every company in China has the capacity to recruit foreigners. Not every company in China has the mandate to issue work visas to company, to international students or to graduates from foreign countries. So when you are searching a job in China, and the funniest thing is that some of these companies don't even know that they cannot recruit foreigners. It is only when you've accepted the job offer and they start your process, before they are told at the immigration or at the labor office, that they don't have the mandate, they don't have the right to recruit foreigners. So the first thing, before you start looking for a job, you need to confirm with this company if they are sure that they have the right or they have the capacity to recruit foreigners. Okay, so that was just a bonus tip. But the number one tip in China to work in China as a foreign student or as a foreign graduate is that you must have a bachelor's degree and at least 2 years of working experience after your bachelor's degree. It means that if you graduate in China with a bachelor's degree, you cannot immediately get a job in China. It is impossible. You need to at least go back home, you work for 2 years, you get a 2 years work experience, then you can come back to China before you get a job. That is the first thing. Now, how can you overcome this first requirement? The advice I'll give you is that after your bachelor's degree in China, you should apply for a master's degree. Now, when you have a master's degree, you have already cleared out the first requirement, which says that you need 2 years of work experience. And the master's degree should be from a top ranking Chinese university. Once you have a master's degree from a top ranking Chinese university, you can immediately apply for a work visa. Now, they won't ask you for 2 years of work experience. The second tip for you to land a job in China after your graduation is that the job that you're applying for should be highly related to your field of studies, which means that if you're graduating as an engineer, it will be impossible for you to apply for a marketing job. Or if you graduate, say, as an IT technician, it will be impossible for you to apply for a job as an accountant. Because, you know, the application process is on point basis, which means that if, for example, they say, okay, you have a master's degree, you have 20 points. If your master's degree is related to your field of studies, you have an additional this number of points. And if it is not related, you have just this number of points. So it will be for your advantage to apply for a job that is related to your field of studies. And another tip, another bonus tip that I would like to share with you guys is that if you're still planning to apply to study in China, you should apply to study things that are really diverse. For example, business related stuff. Like I did an MBA. That was why it was very easy for me to land a job, because with my MBA, I could work even in a construction company. I could work in a business establishment. I could even work in an educational establishment. I could work in a health institution, because with business related stuff, everything in the world is about business. So someone with a business degree, we are diverse. We have a lot of opportunities. We can even do marketing. We can do sales. We can do management. So there are a lot of things that with the business degree, with a management degree, you can do. So and my advice for you is that if you're still applying for the university, it's good to apply to management, business, marketing, and sales related fields, because once you graduate, your opportunities will be much, especially in China. Okay, my third tip for you, if you really want to land a job in China after your graduation, is that take your Chinese studies serious. I wish I knew this when I came to China. I wish I knew this when I came to China from day one, that Chinese can be that key to that your dream job in China. Don't take your Chinese classes for granted. Learn Chinese from HSK1 to HSK2 to HSK3, right up to HSK6. Depending on your level, take your Chinese classes, both at the school level and as an individual level. You don't need to go to class to learn Chinese. Just online, on YouTube, on the internet, you can learn a lot about Chinese. Make Chinese friends, try to communicate, not just for exam sake, but actually for communication sake, because with the Chinese level, with your Chinese, companies will want people that they can communicate with, even if your working language is not Chinese. But just the fact that you're working in a Chinese company, it will be of great advantage for you, because you have to be communicating with your colleagues, you have to be communicating with your boss. Even if your working language is purely English, just the fact that you're working for a Chinese company, learning Chinese, knowing Chinese will be of great advantage to you. So my number three tip is that take your Chinese classes serious from day one. Okay, my number four tip is about networking. There is something in China they call guanxi. It's like, I know this person who knows this person, like a network. And this should be professional networking. And how can you build a professional network in China? Just as you're studying, you should try to make friends, attend events. Like you will see online, they will be advertising a lot of conferences, a lot of events. Even some of them will be online. Once they launch such online programs, they will definitely create a WeChat group. So join such professional WeChat groups. You will meet people who know people who know people, and they will advertise things on such professional groups. That is how you meet other professionals. That is how you might just meet someone who is maybe the manager of a company. Or like, I'm working now in China, and I've had several job opportunities that I've declined just because there are people that I knew. I'll just sit one day and then I'll just get a text message. Oh, are you still searching for a job? We have this opportunity. Someone that I met on the WeChat group and we talked many months ago, and I don't even recognize some of these people. So professional networking in China is very important. Know people, meet people, attend events, attend conferences. Just be so active online while you're in China. Build your professional network. This will greatly help you when it's time for job searching. And the last but not the least advice that I'll give you, which is something general, this only is not only for those who are searching for jobs in China, have an eye-catchy resume and a cover letter. Because you will be having competition, you will be competing with millions of other Chinese nationals and millions of other foreigners in China. So the job search competition in China is so fierce that if you don't stand out, if you don't find a way to stand out from the crowd, then landing a job in China will really be difficult for you. So have a CV that will catch the eye of that human resource manager, that the moment he picks up your CV, even just from the presentation, even just without even reading, just by looking at it, just the presentation, they will say, okay, no, this is something that we are looking for. So your cover letter and your resume should be eye-catchy. So thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen, for watching the video up to this end. These are just the few tips that I have for you about this video. If you have any questions or if you want to know more about this, let me know in the comment section below. And if you like the video, don't forget to give us a thumbs up. If you're not yet subscribed to our channel, please don't leave this video without hitting that subscription button. I'll see you in our next video. Peace out. And I always say, bye-bye. I'll see you.